Hello everyone, welcome back. This is lecture 1, class 9, subject English. In this lecture, we are going to study the last chapter of Behave, that is, If I Were You. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the introduction of the chapter and the explanation of the chapter. If I Were You, written by Douglas James. Introduction. This play is about a playwright named Gerard. How he escapes being killed by an intruder who wants to steal his identity and live peacefully. Gerard fools the intruder, confines him in a cupboard, and finally hands him over to the sergeant. So this is a kind of play where one person is being killed by an intruder who wants to steal his identity. So that's a very interesting play. Let's discuss in detail. Explanation of the chapter. The play is set in a small cottage. The room has an entrance on the right side with a curtain on it. There is another door to the left side of the room, which is in use. The room has simple furniture, that is, a small table to the left, a chair or two, and a small bed on the right side of the room. On the table, a telephone is kept. As the curtain on the stage is rolled up, Gerard is found standing by the table making a phone call. He is of medium height and is wearing spectacles that are in the shape of horns. He is wearing a lounge suit and a green great coat. His voice indicates that he is cultured and well educated. Gerard is speaking on the phone. He says that the person should call him up directly. He adds that he would reach in 10 minutes, bids goodbye and puts the receiver back on the phone. Then he goes to the divan and starts packing the stuff in a traveling bag. While he is busy packing, another man who is similar to Gerard enters the room silently from the right side. He has a gun in one hand. He is dressed in a bright colored dress, an overcoat and a soft hat. He bumps into the table and Gerard turns around at the sound. Gerard speaks pleasantly to the stranger and says that he is surprised to see him. The intruder says that he is glad to find Gerard, happy to see him. He adds that Gerard won't remain happy when he comes to know of his intentions. The intruder asks Gerard to raise his hands. Gerard finds the intruder's behavior to be dramatic and not very natural. The intruder says that he is trying to be composed and, that is, short of words to complete the sentence. Gerard adds that he wants to say that he is trying to be calm and nonchalant, that is, not to show anxiety or enthusiasm. The intruder thanks Gerard for completing the sentence and says that soon he will stop acting smart. He adds that he will torture him and make him crawl. Gerard says that the intruder could ask him anything, but before that he wanted to sit comfortably. The intruder commands Gerard to sit on the chair and sits on the divan. He wants to talk about the two of them. Gerard says that finally he has a person who is concerned about him and wants to know about his past. He adds that he would tell him about his life, how as a child he was stolen by a group of nomads, and why at the age of 32 years was he living all alone at the cottage in Essex. So by saying this, he developed an air of suspense around him. So there was a conversation going on between the Gerard and the intruder, and the intruder was questioning Gerard that why did he live alone in that cottage. And so Gerard thanked him that is anyone still there who is so much interested to know about his life, and definitely he would tell him everything about his life to him. The intruder was not intrigued by Gerard's words. He wanted answers to his set of questions and did not want to hear what Gerard had to say. He asked if Gerard lived there alone. So intruder was interested in knowing if Gerard lived there alone or not, because he wanted to steal his identity. Gerard says that the way in which the intruder spoke made him feel that he was telling him that he lived alone rather than asking him if he did live alone. He added that the intruder's voice was not familiar to imply that he wanted to know about him. So he said that your voice appeared as if you are not asking him, but you are just telling him that he lived there alone and you just want to know about the reason. So the intruder spoke in a very weird way to Gerard. The intruder repeated his question with emphasis and asked Gerard if he lived there alone. Gerard asked, what would the intruder do if he did not answer his question? The intruder warned Gerard that if he did not want any harm, then he should obey his orders. So the intruder threatened Gerard by saying that if he would not answer his questions, then definitely he is going to harm Gerard in any way he can. Gerard spoke intelligently and replied that his good sense reflected in his ability to avoid pain than the mere desire to avoid it. He asked the intruder about his opinion and addressed him Mr. R, as he was not aware about his name, to indicate that he wanted to know his name. So he just made a false guess and tried to made him spoke his name himself. The intruder replied that he need not know his name, and on the other hand asked Gerard his Christian name, that is the name that he was given when he was baptized in the church. Gerard replied that his Christian name was Vincent Charles. Then the intruder said that Gerard was lying. He said that he was not foolish. He was smarter than him and knew that he had a car. He warned Gerard not to befool him. Gerard asked the intruder if he was really an American or was he copying American accent. As the accent in which Gerard spoke was of American, so the intruder confirmed him that if he was really an American or just copying an American accent. The intruder got angry and said that his gun was not a toy. Then again he threatened him that his gun was not a toy. He could harm Gerard and still would get a reply to his question. That means he was threatening him that if directly you are not going to reply, then I can make you reply by threatening with the gun. Gerard showed that he got scared and said that he would be happy to help the intruder. He accepted that he had a car and said that it was in the garage. So he accepted and showed as if he got scared and confirmed him that yes, he had a car. Gerard replied that he rarely had any visitors. He added that very few people underwent the trouble of visiting him, other than the baker, greengrocer, and the milkman. No one else bothered to visit him. So he threatened him in reply that no one used to visit him as no one want to take the chance of getting in trouble. The intruder said that he had come to know that Gerard did not meet tradespeople. So the intruder said that I know that you are not here to trade and you are not here to meet the people, but still I want to know that for what purpose you are living here alone. Gerard commented that the intruder had gone through a lot of trouble to gain information about him. He added that as the intruder knows a lot about him, he should disclose some details about himself too. So Gerard said that if you are so much interested, he added that the intruder had been reserved and had not talked much about himself. So he questioned intruder and asked to tell him something about himself also. When he had gathered so much information about Gerard, then he should tell him that about himself too. The intruder said that he had a lot to talk about himself. In case Gerard thought himself to be smart, then he was smarter. He said that if you think you are smart, then I am smarter. He had brains and used his intelligence to achieve things. He has brain and has used his intelligence to achieve so many things in his life. Gerard commented that the man had just broken into his small cottage, which was not really a big deal, and also did not require much intelligence. So he added that he had not done a great deal. Instead, he had just come into his small cottage, which is really not a big deal. Gerard replied that by seeing the intruder's behavior, he knew that his reason for entering his house would be shocking. Then he inquired about the crime that the intruder specialized in. So he said that the reason of your entering my house would also be as exciting as your replies are. The intruder replied that he specialized in jewel robbing. He added that Gerard's car would be a gift for him because it was very stylish. Gerard commented that in Essex, jewels were hardly found. He wanted to say that it was futile, that means useless, for the intruder to visit the area as he would not find any jewels there. The intruder added that just like jewels, cops were also scarce in Essex and so he could live there peacefully. So he added that since there are no cops, as the chances of robbery and crime is less, so he could live there easily and peacefully. Gerard asked if the intruder wanted to live with him. He commented that the decision was sudden and that he had not invited the intruder to live with him. So it was a shocking. The intruder replied that he did not take the trouble to ask permission from Gerard because he won't be there for long. So he asked that he won't be there for long, so there was useless to ask this question. Gerard said that the man sounded harsh. The intruder replied sarcastically that he would be sorry to do that because he had developed a liking for him. Gerard said that killing a person was a serious crime and advised the intruder not to do so. The intruder said that he was being chased by the police as he had already murdered a person. If he would kill another one, the punishment would still remain the same as they could not hang him to death twice. So again he is trying to threaten him. Gerard said that it meant that the intruder was planning to murder him without any reason. He agreed that the intruder would not lose anything but asked him that what would be he get by killing him. He wanted to know the reason for him to kill Gerard. So when he was threatening him to kill, then Gerard asked him the reason that what he would get if he would kill Gerard. The intruder replied that in return for killing Gerard, he would get freedom. As he had committed a murder, he was hunted by the police and was hiding like a rat. Upon stealing the identity of Vincent Charles Gerard, he would live a life of freedom. He could go to places, eat and sleep without the fear of being caught by the police. So he said that I want to get your identity as I want to be free from the police and cops. So I would kill you and I would take your identity. Gerard commented that in many dramatic plays, the villain was shown to be a foolish person. He would delay being killed and eventually got frustrated due to the delay. Then he would commit some foolish act and get trapped, but the intruder was luckier than such villains. So he said he is trying to comment sarcastically that I think you are not as foolish as the villains in the dramatic plays, as you have told everything and now I want to tell something. Then the intruder replied that he was fine because he was doing this for a reason. He wanted to live in the stolen identity of Vincent Charles Gerard. He enacted Gerard's style of speaking, which he had learnt when he had overheard Gerard talking on the phone. The intruder mimed Gerard and asked how was his performance. So He threatened him again by saying that I can copy you, and started copying him. As when he entered his room, Gerard was speaking to someone on phone and he tried to mimic him in front of him only. D. Intruder commented that it was not so because Gerard's behavior was such. He added that he only required spectacles and he would look just like Gerard. Gerard asked the intruder that what would he do about his clothes. His dress sense was not like him and could put him in trouble. So he asked him that if you would take my identity, then how will you manage with my dressing sense? Gerard said that the intruder did not understand his remark when he said that the intruder was luckier than most of the melodramatic villains. He added that he was not praising the intruder's intelligence, but he wanted to say that the intruder would not kill him until he had a major reason to do so. The intruder ordered Gerard to be quick and disclose all that was going on his mind. He was getting bored by the lengthy conversation, so he wanted to know and speak out his mind. Gerard said that the intruder's plan was to escape the police by killing Gerard and stealing his identity. The intruder said that he had planned everything. He did a job in the town. Something went wrong and he murdered a policeman. Since that day, he was on the run. So how did he kill? Because something went wrong and from that day only he had been running from the police. Gerard said that finally the intruder had reached his cottage while running from the police. The intruder overlooked Gerard's request and continued his speech. He said that Gerard would order things over the phone, would go away and return suddenly. He also wanted to do such things. Getting to know of Gerard was the luckiest happening for him. So he is keen interested to get his identity, even if he had to kill Gerard for that. Gerard commented that the intruder was not intelligent to guess that why was he surrounded by the air of mystery. The intruder prepared to shoot at Gerard as he was getting bored by the conversation. Then Gerard warned the intruder not to act foolish, that if he shot at him, he would be hanged to death. He added that even if he stole his identity, then also he would be hanged to death. Now, this was shocking for the intruder. So, the intruder said that while he was on the run, he reached a town called Aylesbury. There he saw Gerard and overheard two men discussing him. Their discussion revealed that Gerard was strange and mysterious. So from that day he decided to steal his identity. Gerard said that this was the big surprise for the intruder. The reason behind Gerard being a secretive man his was not have visitors and his activities. Being suitable for the intruder was that he was also a wrong man. He said that like intruder he was also a wrong man. He was not an honest man like a school teacher. His game got over when he had to kill someone with a gun. After that, one of his accomplices got caught by the police. They got evidence against Gerard from him. That particular night, Gerard was expecting that the police could raid his house to catch him. And so he had packed his bag and was ready to escape. So he could, the intruder could see a big bag, and so he said that he was trying to escape. Gerard said that the intruder should not be foolish. He asked him to see for himself. He opened the door and stepped to one side so that the intruder could see outside. The intruder leaned forward with the gun and with the gun still. Gerard answered the phone and said that he would not be able to deliver the props in time for the rehearsal of the play because he had been troubled by someone. He added that he would add this incident to his next play. This shows that Gerard was a playwright. He asked the person to send the sergeant to his residence. He added that probably the sergeant could be found in the public bar. So there the intruder was troubled. He was being killed by the Gerard, as he was a playwright and actually he was not being escaped. He was there to deliver the props. So this was about this play, If I Were You. Now your homework is that you have to read the chapter thoroughly and do the textual questions in your fair notebook.